Thanks for joining us here on the web. The Attorney General's office now asking for the public's help in the case of a North Conway teen who returned home this week after disappearing for 9 months. Authorities want to hear from anyone who may have seen Abby Hernandez on North South Road in North Conway Sunday night, the night she came home. Here's Ray Brewer.
New photographs released by investigators show the clothing Abby Hernandez was wearing and the bag she was carrying when she returned home to her mother in North Conway Sunday night. The Attorney General's office says it appears these are the same clothes Hernandez had on and the same bag she had slung over her shoulder when cameras recorded her leaving Kennett High School on October 9, 2013, the day she disappeared. For now, the coincidence just remains one part of the puzzle of Abby's sudden reappearance. Investigators are asking to speak with anyone who saw her or a young woman wearing this clothing in the area of the North South Road in Conway Sunday night.
I was driving on North South Road because I got out of work at 9 and I didn't see anybody.
They're also hoping to make contact with anyone with surveillance system that had cameras recording any portion of the North South Road between 9:30 and 10:30 Sunday night. The state is also trying to find out if anyone was with her. Investigators continue to emphasize that Abby did not have the means to facilitate her own disappearance, nor the ability to provide for herself these past 9 months.
And our thanks to Ray Brewer. Also this morning, we're getting a look at video showing the arrest of a man accused of holding up a Manchester bank while his 6-year-old son was in the getaway car. The man who shot this video, Josh Barsolo, was sitting 3 cars behind accused bank robber Jose Falero when police moved in. Falero is accused of robbing the Citizens Bank on Brown Avenue at gunpoint Monday morning. Police say he made off with $1,800 but didn't get too far. Officers found and arrested him within minutes of the robbery.
I saw the undercover flick on his lights, pull his gun out, and was yelling at the suspect. They did it very quickly and very efficiently and very professionally.
Police say Falero's 6-year-old son was in the car with him. He was not harmed. Falero was arraigned Tuesday on charges of armed robbery and endangering the welfare of a child. Well, the owner of a roofing business will spend the next 3 to 6 years in prison for stealing from his customers. Timothy Currier was convicted earlier this year of entering into contracts with 3 customers, taking more than $18,000 in deposits from them, then skipping out on the work. Currier is the owner of Green Home Energy System in Bow. Besides jail time, he was also ordered to pay back his victims. Meredith and Plymouth police are asking for your help in tracking down a pair of suspected thieves. Officers say these 2 men purchased gift cards at Rite Aid stores in each town using stolen credit card information. The value of the cards totaled $3,000. The men were last seen driving a newer model silver 4-door car seen in this surveillance picture. Anyone with information is asked to contact either Meredith or Plymouth police. The Red Cross says it's in urgent need of blood donations. Right now, it's asking for all blood types. The Red Cross says it's down about 80,000 donations over the last 2.5 months. If you would like to donate, call 1-800-RED-CROSS or visit redcrossblood.org. That's your morning webcast. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you on WMUR-TV at noon.